Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the topic gas power cycles. So this is lecture number 11 in duel cycle, and the topic is problems in duel cycle. So we are going to solve problem from Anna University question paper in the duel cycle, and the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, students will be able to solve problems in duel cycle. And we take example number 6. So in the earlier lecture also we solved 5 problems from the Anna University question paper, and this is example number 6 from May 2013 question paper. The compression and expansion ratios of an oil engine working on air standard duel cycle are 9 and 5 respectively. The initial pressure and temperature are 1 bar and 30 degrees Celsius respectively. The heat liberated at constant volume is twice the heat liberated at constant volume. The heat liberated at constant pressure is twice the heat liberated at constant volume. The expansion and the compression follows the law PV to the power 1.25 equal to constant. Determine pressure and temperature at all the salient points, the mean effective pressure of the cycle, thermal efficiency of the cycle. So take cylinder bore 250 millimeter, diameter is 250 millimeter, and the stroke length is 400 millimeter. So we write down the given data. So compression ratio R equal to 9, expansion ratio R equal to 5, P1 pressure equal to 1 bar, temperature T1 equal to 30 degrees Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin. The heat supplied at constant pressure QCP equal to 2 times of heat supplied constant volume. Polytropic index N equal to 1.25. Diameter of the cylinder is 0.25 meter and the stroke length is 0.4 meter. Now we calculate the specific volume before and after the isentropic compression process. Small V1 equal to RT1 by P1, which is 0.287 into 23. Divided by 100 kilopascal pressure equal to 0.8983 meter cube per kilogram, and V2, small V2 specific volume from the compression ratio V1 by R equal to 0.8983 divided by 9 equal to 0.1 meter cube per kilogram. And for isentropic compression process, so we take the help of the pressure volume diagram of the duel cycle. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 constant pressure heat addition, 4 to 1 isentropic expansion process, and 5 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. So first, for the isentropic compression process, we calculate the pressure and temperature. So P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power N. So where V1 by V2 equal to R, so P1 into R to the power N, which is 1 into 9 to the power 1.25 equal to 15.59 bar, and T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power N minus 1, so V1 by V2 equal to R, so T1 into R to the power N minus 1 equal to 313 into 9 to the power 1.25 minus 1 equal to 542.13 Kelvin. Now we calculate the cutoff ratio. So we are given the compression ratio and the expansion ratio. The ratio of R by RE, compression ratio by expansion ratio, is the cutoff ratio. So we will see how. So R, compression ratio, equal to V1 by V2 divided by RE, expansion ratio is V5 by V4. Now V1 by V2 into, we take the reciprocal, V4 by V1. So V1 as it is, V4 as it is, V2 equal to V3. Look at the PV diagram, V2 equal to V3 and V5 equal to V1. So V5 equal to V1. So V1 by V3 into V4 by V1. So V1 is getting cancelled, V4 by V3. So we have V4 by V3, which is the cutoff ratio. V4 by V3 is the cutoff ratio. So RC equal to R by RE, which is 9 divided by 5 equal to 1.8. So the cutoff ratio is 1.8, and we take this expression, relationship. The heat addition at constant pressure equal to 2 times of heat addition at constant volume. Now we substitute here Cp into T4 minus T3 equal to 2 Cv into T3 minus T2. So we take T4
T3 outside. So Cp T3 into T4 by T3 minus 1 is equal to 2Cv, again T3 outside, so into 1 minus T2 by T3. Now we substitute 1.004, T3 is getting cancelled, T4 by T3 minus 1 equal to 2 into 0.717 into 1 minus T2 equal to 542.13 divided by T3. Now this T4 by T3 equal to V4 by V3, which is 1.8. So substituting 1.004 into 1.8 minus 1 equal to 2 into 0.717 into 1 minus 542.13 divided by T3. So 1 minus 542.13 divided by T3 equal to 0.56 and T3 equal to 1232.1 Kelvin. So temperature at the end of the constant volume heat addition. Now we calculate the constant volume. For constant volume heat addition, P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2. So P3 equal to 35.43 bar. So 15.59 into 1232.1 divided by 542.13 equal to 35.43 bar. And the RP pressure ratio we calculate, P3 by P2 equal to 35.43 divided by 15.59 equal to 2.27. And we calculate the heat addition at the constant volume, which is Cv into T3 minus T2. So Cv equal to 0.717, T3 equal to 1232.1 minus T2 equal to 542.13. So calculating 494.71 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate constant pressure heat addition. So constant pressure heat addition equal to 2Cp equal to 2 times of QC, heat addition and constant volume. So 2 times of 494.71 equal to 989.42. Now the heat addition constant pressure equal to Cp into T4 minus T3, which is 989.42. So substituting 1.004 into T4 minus 1232.1 equal to 989.42. So solving this equation, will get T4 equal to 2217.58 Kelvin. Then we calculate the heat supply, total heat supply. Heat supply equal to QS equal to QCP plus QCV. So 989.42 plus 494.71 equal to 1484.13 kilojoules per kilogram. And for isentropic expansion process, we calculate the pressure P5 and temperature T5. So T5 equal to T4 into V4 by V5 to the power n minus 1. And this V4 by V5 equal to RC by R. So T4 into RC by R to the power n minus 1. So substitute numerical value is 2217.58 into RC equal to 1.8. The R equal to 9 to the power 1.25 minus 1 equal to 1483 Kelvin. So calculating it is 1483 Kelvin. And the P5 pressure at the end of the expansion process, P5 equal to P4 into V4 by V5 to the power N. Once again, V4 by V5 equal to RC by R. So P4 into RC by R to the power N, which is 35.43 into 1.8 divided by 9 to the power 1.25 equal to 4.74 bar. Now we calculate the air standard efficiency. So dual cycle efficiency equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power N minus 1 into RP into RC to the power N minus 1 divided by RP minus 1 plus N into RP into RC minus 1. So substituting all the numerical values, 1 minus 1 by 9 to the power 1.25 minus 1 multiplied by 2.2. So RP equal to 2.27, RC equal to 1.8, N equal to 1.25 minus 1 divided by 2.27 minus 1 plus 1.25 into 2.27 into 1.8 minus 1. So calculating the value, this is 0.391, which is 39.1%. Then work done during the dual cycle, W equal to eta into heat supplied, 0.391 into 1484.13 equal to 580.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the mean effective pressure, MEP equal to net work done divided by the change in the volume, swept volume V1 minus V2. So 580.3 divided by 0.8983 minus 0.1, which is 726.92 kilopascal. And the answer to the problem, the pressure and temperature at all salient points. Pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So, P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 15.59 bar, P3 equal to 35.43 bar, P4 equal to 35.43 bar, and P5 equal to 4.74 bar. Temperature in Kelvin, T1 equal to 313 Kelvin, T2 equal to 542.13, T3 equal to 1232.1, T4 equal to 2217.58, and T5 equal to 1483. So, theoretical air standard efficiency is 39.1% and the mean effective pressure is 726.92 kilopascal. We take the next example, example number 7, again from the November 2013 question paper. A dual combustion air standard cycle has a compression ratio of 10. The constant pressure part of the combustion takes place at the 40 bar. The highest and lowest temperature of the cycle are 1727 degree Celsius and 27 degree Celsius respectively. The pressure at the beginning of the compression process is 1 bar. Calculate the pressure and temperature at the key points of the cycle, the heat supplied at constant volume, heat supplied at constant pressure, heat rejected, work output, efficiency and the mean effective pressure. So, we write down the given data. So, compression ratio R equal to 10, P3 equal to P4 equal to 40 bar, T1 equal to 27 degree Celsius which is 300 Kelvin and T4 equal to 1727 degree Celsius which is 2000 Kelvin and P1 equal to 1 bar. So, we take the isentropic compression process. So, with reference to the pressure volume diagram, so 1 to 2 is isentropic compression process. For the process, we calculate the pressure and temperature. So, pressure P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma. So, V1 by V2 equal to R compression ratio. So, P1 into R to the power gamma equal to 1 into 10 power 1.4 equal to 25.12 bar. And T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is T1 into V1 by V2 equal to R to the power gamma minus 1. Into which is equal to 300 into 10 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 753.6 Kelvin. Now, for the constant volume heat addition process, we calculate the RP equal to P3 by P2, which is T3 by T2. So, P3 is given here. So, P3 is 40 divided by 25.12 equal to 1.59. And from here, we calculate T3 equal to T2 into RP, which is 753.6. into 1.59 equal to 1198.2 Kelvin. Then the amount of heat supplied at constant volume QCV equal to CV into T3 minus T2 which is 0.717 into 1198.2 minus 753.6 equal to 318.8 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we take the constant pressure heat addition. So RC equal to V4 by V3 which is T4 by T3. So we are given T4 2000 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1198.2, so the cutoff ratio equal to 1.67. And we calculate the heat addition at constant pressure QCP equal to CP into T4 minus T3, which is 1.004 into 2000 minus 1198.2 equal to 805.81 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the total heat addition. So, total heat addition equal to heat addition at constant volume plus heat addition at constant pressure. So, 318.8 plus 805.81 equal to 1124.61 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the isentropic expansion process, we take isentropic expansion process to calculate the pressure P5 and temperature T5. So, T5 equal to T4 into V4 by V5 to the power gamma minus 1, where V4 by V5 equal to RC by R. So, T4 into RC by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 2000 into 1.67 divided by 10 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 977.5 Kelvin. And P5 equal to P4 into V4 by V5 to the power gamma, where again V4 by V5 equal to RC by R. So, P4 into RC by R to the power gamma equal to 40 into 1.67 divided by 10 to the power 1.4 equal to 2.66 bar. Then we calculate the heat rejected. So, QR equal to CV into T5 minus T1. So 0.717 into 977.5 minus 300 equal to 485.8 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the work done. Work done equal to W equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected. So 1124.61 minus 485.8 equal to 638.81 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the air standard efficiency. Again, we take the same equation, 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into Rp Rc to the power gamma minus 1 divided by Rp minus 1 plus gamma into Rp into Rc minus 1. Substituting all the numerical values, 1 minus 1 by 10 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 1.59 into 1.67 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.59 minus 1 plus in plus 1.4 into 1.59 into 1.67 minus 1. So calculating, this is 0.568, which is 56.8%. Then we calculate the specific volume for the isentropic compression process. So V1 equal to RT1 by P1. So 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.861 metric cube per kilogram. And the R value equal to V2 value equal to V1 divided by R with reference to the compression ratio. So 0.861 divided by 10 equal to 0.0861 metric cube per kilogram. Then we calculate the mean effective pressure. So mean effective pressure equal to net to work done divided by the V1 minus V2 sub to volume. So 638.81 divided by 0.861 minus 0.0861 equal to 824.4 kilopascal. Then the answer to the problem, pressure and temperature at all salient points, the pressure is in bar, temperature is in Kelvin. So pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 25.12 bar, P3 equal to P4 equal to 40 bar, and P5 equal to 2.66 bar. Temperature T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, T2 equal to 753.6 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1198.2 Kelvin, T4 equal to 2000 Kelvin, and T5 equal to 977.5 Kelvin. Heat supplied at constant volume 318.8 kilojoules per kilogram. Heat supplied constant pressure 805.81 kilojoules per kilogram. Heat rejected 485.8 kilojoules per kilogram. Work output 638.81 kilojoules per kilogram, and the efficiency 56.8%, and the mean effective pressure 824.4 kilopascal. Then example number 8 from the May 2013 question paper. An air standard dual cycle has a compression ratio of 16.5. The compression begins at 1 bar and 50 degrees Celsius. The maximum pressure is 70 bar. The heat transfer to the air at constant pressure is equal to that of constant volume. Estimate the pressure and temperature at all cardinal points of the cycle and the cycle efficiency. So we write down the given data. So we are given R equal to 16.5 compression ratio, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 50 degrees Celsius, which is 323 Kelvin, P3 equal to P4 equal to 70 bar. And we are given heat addition at constant volume is equal to heat addition at constant pressure. So we take the isentropic compression process. So P2 equal to P1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 into 16.5 to the power 1.4 equal to 50.64 bar. And T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 323 into 16.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 991.3 Kelvin. And with reference to the PV diagram for the dual cycle, for we take the constant volume heat addition process, so we calculate the RP. We are given P3, the maximum pressure in the cycle. So P3 by P2 is the RP. 70 divided by 50.64 equal to 1.38. And from this equation, we calculate T3 equal to T2 into P3 by P2. Which is 991.3 into 1.38 equal to 1368 Kelvin. Now the heat addition at constant volume Cv into T3 minus T2. So substituting numerical values 0.718 into 1368 minus 991.3 equal to 270.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And we are given heat addition at constant volume equal to heat addition at constant pressure, which is 270.5. And the heat addition at constant pressure equal to Cp into T4 minus T3, which is 270.5. So, substitute numerical value is 1.005 into T4 minus 1368 equal to 270.5. And solving this equation, T4 equal to 1637.1 Kelvin. And we calculate the cutoff ratio, Rc equal to V4 by V3, which is T4 by T3 equal to 1637.1 divided by 1368 equal to 1.2. Then we take the isentropic expansion process to calculate the pressure and temperature at the end of the expansion. So, T5 equal to T4 into V4 by V5 to the power gamma minus 1, which is T4 into Tc Rc by R to the power gamma minus 1. V4 by V3 equal to Rc by R. So, which is substitute numerical value is 1637.1 into Rc equal to 1.2. R value compression ratio is 16.5. So, 1.2 divided by 16.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 573.8 Kelvin. And the P5, the pressure at the end of the expansion, P5 equal to P4 into V4 by V5 to the power gamma. So, where again V4 by V5 equal to Rc by R. Compression ratio divided by the, cutoff ratio divided by the compression ratio. So, substitute numerical value is 70 into 1.2 divided by 16.5 to the power 1.4 equal to 1.78 bar. Then we calculate the efficiency of dual cycle. Dual cycle efficiency equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So, into Rp into Rc to the power gamma minus 1 divided by Rp minus 1 plus gamma into Rp into Rc minus 1. So, substituting numerical values 1 minus 1 by 16.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 1.38 into 1.2 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.38 minus 1 plus 1.4 into 1.38 into 1.2 minus 1. So, using the calculator, calculating the value, the answer is 0.668, which is 66.8%. So, the answer to the problem, the pressure and temperature at all salient points, pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 50.64 bar, P3 equal to P4 equal to 70 bar, P5 equal to 1.78 bar. And the temperature T1 is 323 Kelvin, T2 is 991.3 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1368 Kelvin, T4 equal to 1637.1 Kelvin, and T5 equal to 573.8 Kelvin. The efficiency of the cycle is 66.8%. And we take the next example, example number 9 from May 2019 question paper. In an air standard dual cycle, the pressure and temperature at the beginning of the compression are 1 bar and 57 degrees Celsius respectively. The heat supplied in the cycle is 1250 kilojoules per kilogram. 2/3 of this being added at constant volume and rest is in constant pressure. If the compression ratio is 16, determine the maximum pressure and temperature in the cycle, thermal efficiency and MEP, mean effective pressure. So, we write down the given data, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 57 degrees Celsius, which is 330 Kelvin, heat supplied equal to 1250 kilojoules per kilogram. So, heat supplied constant volume QCV equal to 2 by 3 of QS and heat supplied constant pressure equal to 1 by 3 of QS, R compression ratio equal to 16. We take the compression ratio, compression process, isentropic compression process to calculate the pressure and temperature at the end of the compression process. P2 equal to P1 into R to the power gamma, which is 1 into 16 to the power 1.4 equal to 48.5 bar. T2 equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 330 into 16 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 1000.4 Kelvin. Then we take the PV diagram of the dual cycle. So, 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 constant pressure heat addition, 4 to 1 isentropic expansion and 5 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. So we take constant volume heat addition process. So QCV equal to CV into T3 minus T2, which is 2 by 3 times of QS. So substituting numerical values, 0.718 into T3 minus 1000.4 equal to 2 by 3 times of 1250. So calculating T3 equal to 2161 Kelvin. We calculate the pressure ratio RP. RP equal to P3 by P2 equal to T3 by T2. So which is 2161 divided by 1000.4 equal to 2.16. And this pressure P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2, which is 48.5 into 2.16 equal to 104.76 bar. Now for the constant pressure heat addition process, so QCP equal to CP into T4 minus T3, which is 1 by 3 QS. So substituting numerical values, 1.005 into T4 minus 2161 equal to 1 by 3 times of 1250. Now you calculate from this equation T4 equal to 2575.6 Kelvin. Now RC cutoff ratio equal to V4 by V3, which is T4 by T3 equal to 2575.6 divided by 2161 equal to 1.19. Then the efficiency of the dual cycle. So we write the equation 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RP into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by RP minus 1 plus gamma into RP into RC minus 1. So substituting all the numerical values, 1 minus 16 to the power 1.4 into 2.16 into 1.19 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 2.16 minus 1 plus 1.4 into 2.16 into 1.19 minus 1. Calculating the value, this gives 0.666, which is 66.6%.
Now we calculate the specific volume before and after the compression process. So V1 equal to RT1 by P1, which is 0.287 into 330 divided by 100, which is 0.9471 metric cube per kilogram. And V2 specific volume, V2 equal to, from the compression ratio, V1 by R, which is 0.9471 divided by 16, equal to 0.059 metric cube per kilogram. Then we calculate the work done. Work done W equal to eta into heat supplied, 0.666 into 1250 equal to 832.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the mean effective pressure is net to work done divided by the V1 minus V2 sub to volume, which is 832.5 divided by 0.9471 minus 0.059 equal to 937.4 kilopascal. Now the answer to the problem, maximum pressure is 104.6 bar, maximum temperature is 2575.6 Kelvin, thermal efficiency is 66.6%, and the mean effective pressure is 937.4 kilopascal. So we stop here. So these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. There are other books available for this subject. You can refer to the list of books. I conclude this lecture by a quote from Dr. Kalam. Dream is not which you see while sleeping. It is something that does not let you sleep. So we are all working hard to be a successful person in our life. So we continue to work hard to be a successful man in our life. And these are all the books I published earlier. So design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject mentioned here. Also the solutions for the gate question paper I upload in the YouTube channel. It is free of cost. You please subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. So you please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video, and you subscribe the channel, and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. Thank you. We'll meet again in another video lecture.